I'm Ricardo Juncos, 45 years old, team owner of Juncos Racing. Yeah, I think as a team owner, I was always feel like I was progressively, slowly going up from go-kart to Pro Mazda. So we did Pro Mazda 2009 and we're still doing that. But clearly in the last 4 years was kind of a quick pump and growing really fast with the addition of the Indy Lights in 2015 and then 2017, already Indy 500 with two cars, then IndyCar partial seasons then since then, and the DPI program almost full time in 2019. Biggest challenge as a team owner, huh? It's just no, I don't think it's one, I think it's many. It's not an easy position. I think motor racing, when you think about it, is very complicated. It's hard to say if it's the complicated business that you can be in, but sometimes it's like, but I don't know anything else to compare, but clearly you gotta deal with the technical aspects of poor racing and all the aspects that are related to race car itself and the setups, but then you involve it with driver coaching and dealing with the drivers, the psychology of drivers' mindset, parents, sponsors, and the business itself, accounting, taxes, contracts, insurance. It's very complicated business. So I feel like I like to live intense. I always live so intense, but this is a little bit too much. The biggest moment for me as a team owner is like, again, the magnitude can be a little higher. For example, everybody will say, and I can say that probably the most when we qualifying for the Indy 500. Because we were getting to that, the whole event already in disadvantage. So we were not able to secure the sponsor. The car was white because the sponsor was white color and black. So we decided to paint the car in black. A week before the first practice, money never showed up, the deal fell through, and here we are with a white car, no sponsor, facing the Indy 500. And then we were fast. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, so you start getting anxious and say, wow, we can be actually being in the top 10 on the Indy 500 is huge, and you have a lot of pressure, and then people are talking about it, and then everything collapsed with this crash. So when we finally made it, and we also bump Alonso and McLaren out, which we didn't know at that time who was, we don't care, we are on the show, but then because of that, I think that was an extra ingredient that magnified everything even more. So clearly that was the biggest moment. Yeah, I think the precision in any team is important, like in any sport. You can relate that to soccer or American football or whatever. I think it's so important. I think more than anything is because you start building the relationship between the new driver that joining the team or a driver that continues the team, but the relationship between the engineer, mechanic, the driver, the system and the philosophy of the team, if it's in good direction and you, the more involved, the more you engage on that, that's gonna give you success. In your situation, coming to the academy in the last 2 years, I think is great because we are in this country that is impossible to try to test anywhere else other than Florida. And obviously we start with Nature for a long time and I think you're doing a great job. Your idea is fantastic, like I told you the first time. I agree 100%, but you feel like a family here as well. And the fact that we have different series and we divide it in sections, in sessions, like it's good for us because that's the way a race weekend is actually. So I'm really happy to be part of this, the Academy Winter Series, track times and private days that we call it, but I'm very happy and I think it's so important for us. Like we started this last year and we ended up winning really good this Indy Pro 2000 Championship, and I think part of the reason is because of the preparation.